Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, I will explain you how to configure the cascading combo box using the view combo box of Synfusion. Look at this online example. You can see here the series of combo box components. You can also notice that when I select the country name from country's combo box, the respective state combo box is enabled now. Similarly, after I choose any state from the state's combo box, the city combo box gets enabled. So now, let me show you the steps to render such a series of combo box components and how to configure the value of the single combo box that depends on another combo box value using my existing Getting Started application. First, let me open my existing Getting Started application where I have added the view combo box with remote data. If you want to know how to create a simple view combo box, then you can listen to my Getting Started video, the link for which is shown in the above YouTube card. Also, you can download this existing Getting Started example from the GitHub link, which I have shared in the description part below. Now, to have better clarity, I am replacing this remote data with JSON data collection, which contains an array of objects with two fields, namely country name and country ID. Also, I have mapped country name field to text property and country ID field to value property. I have assigned the country names to data source. So, let me change the placeholder property value as select a country. Also, ensure whether these data item and data fields variables are assigned to the data source and fields property of the combo box. So here, you can see the combo box showing country names. Now, let me show you the steps to configure the cascading combo box. To create a cascading combo box, first, I need to render a series of combo box components. So, I will define one more combo box inside the template section. Here, I'm going to assign state names as data source for this newly defined combo box. Therefore, within the data function, let me define a variable state data item and assign JSON data source, which contains an array of objects with two fields, namely state name and state ID. For this data source, the appropriate data source field should be mapped to the fields property of the combo box component. So, I need to define a variable state data fields and map these fields state name to text property and state ID to value property. Now, let me assign these variables state data item and state data fields to the data source and fields property of the combo box. Along with this, I have also defined a placeholder property and set its value as select a state, as the pop-up displays the selected country state names. And now, you can see the combo box components rendered one after the other. You can also notice that the state combo box components is enabled and displaying the state names even though the country combo box has no selected value. So, to disable the state combo box and to populate the state names only based on the selected country value, I need to write logic for handling this scenario. First, to disable the state combo box component, I will set its enabled property to false. For that, I will define a variable enable combo box and set its value as false within data function. Then, I will assign this variable enable combo box to the enabled property of the state combo box. I will also define a query property to state combo box and set its value as null at its initial load. For that, let me define another variable child data query with null value and assign it to query property. And I will explain about the need of this query property a bit later. Next, I will populate state names to state combo box based on the selected country value. For that, I will map the appropriate state names to relevant countries in the first combo box component. So, let me define one more field country ID with appropriate values mapping to the state combo box data source items. Then, within country combo box code, I'm going to define change event with relevant handler to load data on state combo box component based on the selected value in the country combo box. Now, I will start to define onCountryChangeEvent handler. Therefore, let me add methods section first and define this event handler within it. Here, if a country name is selected, then this changeEvent will be triggered. So, within this onCountryChange method, I need to enable the state combo box component by passing the value true to this enable combo box variable. Now, I'm going to fetch state names based on the selected country value. So, I will create a reference to country combo box by defining the ref attribute to access the country combo box selected value. Also, I need to form a query and assign it to a variable child data query to fetch state names based on the country combo box selected value. To make use of this query, let me import query type from Synfusion EJ2 data repository. Look at the combo box components. The state combo box is disabled initially. And if I select any country name from country combo box, only then the state combo box gets enabled, showing the relevant state names based on the selected country value. Like this, you can render n number of combo box components and configure each of its value depending on the other. Okay, let me summarize some of the important points now. We have seen how to add series of view combo box of Synfusion to the view application. Also, we have seen how to configure cascading combo box. If you would like to see the working of this example, you can download it from the GitHub link which is shared in the description part below. If you find this video as useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel. Thanks for watching this video.